Hello friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. And through this lecture, we will see a few more problems on the refrigeration. This is refrigeration problem part 3. So we revise once again the vapor compression refrigeration cycle. The cycle shown here is the basic cycle, which is ideal basic cycle for vapor compression system. 1 to 2 is the constant pressure evaporation, and 2 to 3 is the isentropic compression, and 3 to 4 is the constant pressure condensation, and 4 to 1 is the constant enthalpy throttling device expansion process. And the pressure enthalpy diagram for all the 4 processes are also given there in the right side. The coefficient of performance, it is defined as refrigeration effect by the divided by the compressor work input. So refrigeration effect is the enthalpy difference across the evaporator. Compressor work input is the enthalpy difference across the compressor. So H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2. Refrigeration capacity, RE equal to M, mass of the refrigerant into enthalpy difference across the evaporator. And the power required to drive the compressor, P equal to mass of the refrigerant into enthalpy difference across the compressor. And we take the example number 9. A refrigeration plant uses CO2 as the refrigerant, produces 4.5 tons of refrigeration. The condensation and the evaporator temperatures are 30 degrees Celsius and minus 20 degrees Celsius respectively, whose properties are shown in the table flow. So the properties of the CO2 are given here. And the refrigerant temperature after compression is 42 degrees Celsius. Determine the heat rejected from the condenser in kilowatts. Power input to the compressor. Percentage of refrigerant vapor after throttling. COP and relative COP. So this is from the Anna University question paper in May 2013. And the given data are refrigeration effect equal to 4.5 tons. Condenser temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature is minus 20 degrees Celsius, and temperature after compression is 42 degrees Celsius. And the cycle for the process, various processes are shown here. So 2 is the saturated vapor before compression, and 4 is the saturated liquid after condensation, 3 is the superheated vapor after compression. So specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the end of the compression, so H3 equal to HG3 plus CP into T3 minus T3S. So HG3 is the vapor 365.13 plus CP is 155.82 into temperature difference T3 minus T3S equal to 42 minus 30, which is 1034.97 kilojoules per kilogram. The specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the beginning of the evaporation, so H1 equal to H4, which is HF4, that is at the 0.4 it is saturated liquid, which is 304.55 kilojoules per. Specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the beginning of the compression, which is H2 equal to HG2, which is 436.89 kilojoules per kilogram. So here it is saturated vapor. Now the mass of the refrigerant, M equal to refrigeration effect or heat extracted by the enthalpy difference across the evaporator. So the refrigeration effect is given as 4.5 ton. So tons of refrigeration. So 4.5 ton equal to 4.5 into 3.5. So 3.5 is the 1 ton of refrigeration equal to 3.5 kilojoules per second. So it is 4.5 into 3.5 divided by the H2 minus H1. 436.89 minus 304.55 equal to 0.12 kilograms per second. So the mass of the refrigerant flowing through the circuit is 0.12 kilograms per second. Now heat rejected in the condenser, M into enthalpy difference across the condenser. So inlet enthalpy is H3, exit enthalpy is H4. So M into H3 minus H4, which is 0.12 into 1034.97 minus 304.55 equal to 87.65 kilojoules per kilogram. And power required to drive the compressor, M into H3 minus H2, which is 0.12 into 1037.97 minus 436.89 equal to 71.76 kilowatts. And the percentage of refrigerant vapor after throttling. So what is the vapor percentage of vapor at the end of the throttling process? We know the H1 value, which is wet vapor, H1 equal to HF1 plus X1 into HG1 minus HF1, substituting 304.55 equal to 154.45 plus X1 into 436.89 minus 154.45. So calculating X1 equal to 0.53. So that means the percentage of vapor, refrigerant vapor after throttling is 53%. So dryness fraction after throttling X1 equal to 0.53. And theoretical COP is enthalpy, based on the enthalpy values. So H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2, which is 436.89 minus 304.55 divided by 1034.97 minus 436.89 equal to 0.2. The actual COP equal to refrigeration effect divided by the work done or the power input by the to the compressor. So 4.5 tons of refrigeration into 3.5 divided by power input is 71.76 kilowatts. So the actual COP is 0.219. The relative COP is the actual COP divided by the theoretical COP. So 0.219 divided by 0.22 equal to 0.98. So relative COP equal to 0.99. And the answers are heat rejected from the condenser is 87.65 kilowatts. Power input to the compressor is 71.76 kilowatts. Percentage of refrigerant vapor after throttling is 0.53. Actual theoretical COP equal to 0.22 and relative COP equal to 0.99. These are all the answers. Then we take the example 10. The temperature limits of ammonia refrigeration system are 25 degrees Celsius and minus 10 degrees Celsius. So the evaporator temperature is minus 10 degrees Celsius and condenser temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. If the gas is dry at the end of the compression and calculate the COP of the cycle assuming no undercooling after or no undercooling of the liquid ammonia. The properties of ammonia are given below. So the temperature 25 degrees Celsius, minus 10 degrees Celsius, liquid heat, that means HF value, latent heat, which is HFG value, and liquid entropy, SF value. Now here, the SFG value is not given. That is the challenge in the problem. Condenser temperature equal to 25 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature is minus 10 degrees Celsius, and this is the cycle. So because what is the condition? The gas is dry at the end of the compressor. So, end of the compressor is 3, where it is dry condition. So, specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the end of the compression. So, H3 equal to HG3 equal to 298.9 plus 116.94. So, this is HF, this is HFG, which is 1465.84 kilojoules per kilogram. So, this is HF plus HFG. Specific enthalpy of the refrigerant. At the beginning of the evaporation, H1 equal to H4 equal to HF4, which is 298.9 kilojoules per kilogram. And to find the drainage fraction of the steam of the drainage fraction of the refrigerant at the 0.2, we have S2 equal to S3, and S2 equal to wet vapor, so SF2 plus X2 into SFG2 equal to SG3. So here SFG is not given, SG value is not given. So refer to the table. So we are given only SF value. So SFG or the SG values are not given. So here we have to use the relationship. Latent heat entropy of the entropy for the conversion. Entropy for the conversion of vapor into liquid into gas. So this value, SFG value equal to HFG divided by the temperature. So, this is from the entropy equal to, we have the second law of equation, delta S equal to delta Q divided by 2, delta Q divided by T. So, from that, delta S, the entropy equal to H divided by temperature, enthalpy divided by the temperature. So, similarly, SG value equal to HG3 divided by the T3. Now, SF2 value is given, X2 value is unknown. HFG2 value is 1297.68 and T2 is the temperature of the evaporator minus 10 to plus 273 is equal to HG value is 1465.84 and T3 is the temperature of the condenser or the end of the compression. This is 25 plus 273. for calculating X2 equal to 0.88. Now the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant before compression, H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HFG2, which is 135.37 plus 0.88 into 1297.68 equal to 1277.3 kilojoules per kilogram. So calculating the COP, H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2, substituting all the value, it is 5.19. So the answer is COP equal to 5.19. We take the example number 11. So a simple R2 plant is to develop 5 tons of refrigeration. The condenser and evaporator temperatures to be 40 degrees Celsius and minus 10 degrees Celsius respectively. Determine the refrigerant flow rate in kilograms per second, volume flow rate handled by the compressor in meter cube per second, compressor discharge temperature, heat rejected to the condenser in kilowatts, COP, power required to drive the compressor. How does the COP compare with that of Carnot refrigerator between 40 degrees Celsius and minus 10 degrees Celsius? So this is from the university question paper, May 2006. So here the given data is ton of refrigeration is 5, condenser temperature is 40 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature is minus 10 degrees Celsius. The properties are not given in the question paper, so we have to take the properties of R12 from the refrigeration table. So you can ask for the refrigeration table. If the properties are not given, you can take the properties from the table. So this is the extraction from the table. So minus 10 degrees Celsius, 40 degrees Celsius, all the values I have taken from the table. So enthalpy value, entropy value, specific heat of the vapor and the liquid. Now this is the temperature entropy diagram for the cycle. So the end of the evaporation or beginning of the compression saturated vapor, it is superheated vapor after compression, and here it is saturated liquid. End of the condensation is saturated liquid. This is the standard cycle. The specific enthalpy of refrigerant at the beginning of the compression, H2 equal to HG2 equal to 348.17 HG2, right? 348.17 kilojoules per kilogram. Specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the beginning of the evaporation, H1 equal to H4, which is HF4. So 40 degree HF4 equal to 239.03. So 239.03 kilojoules per kilogram. And to calculate the temperature at the end of the compression, T3, so I take S2 equal to S3. So this is the condition, S2 equal to S3. So using this condition, SG2 equal to SG3 plus Cp into logarithmic of T3 by T3S. So 1.5639 equal to 1.5459 plus 0.762 into logarithmic of T3 by 40 plus 273. So we will get 320.4 Kelvin or 47.48 degree Celsius. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the end of the compression, so H3 equal to HG3 plus Cp into T3 minus T3S, which is 368.81 plus 0.762 into 47.48 minus 40 equals 374.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And mass of the refrigerant is M equal to mass of the refrigeration effect divided by the heat divided by the enthalpy difference H2 minus H1. And substituting, this is 5 ton of refrigeration. So 5 into 3.5 divided by 348.17 minus 239.09 equal to 0.16 kilograms per second. So the mass of the refrigerant is 0.16 kilograms per second. And the volume flow rate of refrigerant, M into VG. So the VG equal to point at the temperature, condensed temperature 0.01837. So the volume flow rate is 2.94 10 power minus 4 meter cube per second. And the heat rejected in the condenser, M into H3 minus H4, which is 0.16 into heat rejected in the condenser, M into H3 minus H4 equal to 0.16 into 374.5 minus 239.03 equal to 21.67 kilowatts. Power required to drive the compressor, M into H3 minus H2, it is 0.16 into 374.5 minus 348.12 equal to 4.22 kilowatts. And the coefficient of performance, COP equal to H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2, substituting all the enthalpy value, this is 4.13. And the Carnot COP, based on the temperature, this is the lowest temperature in the cycle divided by highest temperature minus lowest temperature, so this is 5.26. So Carnot COP is 5.26 and the cycle, vapor compression cycle, COP equal to 4.13. So these are the answers. Refrigeration flow rate is 0.16 kilograms per second. Volume flow rate handled by the compressor is 2.94 × 10⁻⁴ m³/s. Compressor discharge temperature is 47.48 degrees Celsius. Heat rejected in the condenser is 21.67 kilowatts. COP equal to 4.13. Power required to drive the compressor is 4.22 kilowatts. And Carnot COP is 5.26. Now take the example 12. A refrigeration machine is required to produce ice at 0 degrees Celsius from water at 20 degrees Celsius. The machine has the condenser temperature of 298 Kelvin, while the evaporator temperature is 268 Kelvin. The relative efficiency of the machine is 0.50%, and 6 kg of Freon 12 refrigerant is circulated through the system per minute. The refrigerant enters the compressor with the dryness fraction 0.6, and specific heat of water is 4.187 kilojoules per kilogram, and lateral heat of ice is 335 kilojoules per kilogram. Calculate the amount of ice produced in 24 hours. And the given data, water temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, ice temperature is 0 degrees Celsius, condenser temperature is 298 Kelvin, which is 25 degrees Celsius, evaporator temperature is 268 Kelvin, which is minus 5 degrees Celsius, relative COP is 0.5, mass of the refrigerant is 6 kilograms per minute, which is 0.1 kilograms per second, X2 value, dryness fraction at the end, beginning of the compressor is 0.6, specific heat of water is 4.187 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and latent heat of ice is 335 kilojoules per kilogram. So here again, the properties of refrigerant F12, the Freon 12 is not given. So we have to take the value from the table and the extraction from the. So the properties are taken from the table, refrigeration table for minus 5 degrees Celsius and 25 degrees Celsius. So enthalpy, HF and HG value, entropy, SF and SG value. And this is the temperature, entropy and pressure enthalpy diagram for the given condition. So the vapor is wet with the dryness fraction 0.6 at the end of the compression. So X2 equal to 0.6. Specific enthalpy of the refrigerant at the entry of the evaporator, H1 equal to H4 equal to HF4, which is 223.93 kilojoules per kilogram. And the, at the entry of the compressor, the X2 value is given 0.6. So here H2 equal to HF2 plus X2 into HG2 minus HF2, substituting 195.37 plus 0.6 into 350.44 minus 195.37 equal to 288.4 kilojoules per kilogram. And here we have to calculate the enthalpy. Enthalpy at the end of the compression. So the dryness fraction value is not given here. And now to calculate the dryness fraction, I take once again S2 equal to S3. S2 equal to SF2 plus X2 into SG2 minus SF2, which is equal to SF3 plus X3 into SG3 minus SF3, substituting all the values, X3 equal to 0.53. And the specific enthalpy of the refrigerant after compression, H3 equal to HF3 plus X3 into HG3 minus HF3, that is equal to 223.93 plus 0.53 into 363.25. 225 minus 223.93 equal to 297.75 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the theoretical coefficient of performance. So based on the enthalpy values, H2 minus H1 divided by H3 minus H2 equal to 288.4 minus 223.93 divided by 297.75 minus 288.4, which is 6.9. And the actual COP equal to relative COP into theoretical COP. Relative COP is given as 0.5 into 6.9 equal to 3.45. That is what the actual COP. And to calculate the mass of the ice, we have to equate the refrigeration effect equal to heat extracted in the ice formation. So M into H2 minus H1 is the refrigeration effect. We know all the values in the left hand side. Mass of the refrigerant is 0.1 and H2 equal to 288.4. And H1 equal to 223.93. That is equal to mass of the ice, which is the unknown, into the ice is produced from 20 degree Celsius water at ice at 0 degree Celsius. So CPW into 20 minus 0 plus lateral heat of the ice. So 4.187 is the CPW specific heat of water into 20 plus 335, calculating and mass of the ice equal to 0.015 kilograms per second, which is equal to 1296 kilograms per day. So multiplying by 24 into 3600. So that gives 1296 kilograms per second. So the mass of the ice produced per day is 1296 kilograms per day, 1296 kilograms per day. So this is the end of the lecture on the problems on the refrigeration. If you look at all the problems, we have taken, you study the problem thoroughly, write down the given data, understand the problem, and you take the appropriate, the temperature entropy diagram and the pressure enthalpy diagram. You calculate enthalpy for all the 4 points. In fact, end of the evaporator, end of the compressor, and end of the condenser. So H2, H3, H4 values you have to find out from the table. And if the values are not given, you have to calculate appropriately. So once you have the H2, H3 and H4, you can calculate everything in the vapor combustion refrigeration cycle. So you listen to the video and practice the problem. All the best. Thank you once again.